stroke has big knock-on effects, people being unwell on ship. Fortunately, most voyages are of a short duration, but a month at sea, a lot can happen, and particularly in Antarctica where you're remote. This is the consultation room and surgery where the history and examination by the resident doctor done. 90% of the work is taken in that room. If things deteriorate, there's a resuscitation bay with x-rays and monitoring equipment. Here's a convalescent and recovery two-bed ward with attached ensuite for two patients. We do a great job in vetting the people here. In the pre-employment physical, we've got a huge database of history and examination and testing, so we do make sure they're in the best possible condition prior to leaving. We've got the latest digital radiology technology where we can take an x-ray and the image is Bluetooth to the computer. Into the surgical suite. This is the scrub room where we have machines for PCR testing, biochemistry and blood transfusion, as well as the name that suggests a scrub area for pre-operation preparation. Into the main operating theatre where we have the ability to perform general anaesthetics. It's also a storage area for pharmaceuticals and non-pharmaceuticals. On a ship, things have to be stashed away. The weather can be violent, and so preparation for procedure is quite involved. COVID is very much on our minds. We have state-of-the-art PCR testing for COVID, which gives us a turnaround of 40-50 minutes from patient to results to give us their status. Best job in the world. Great environment to work with, and fabulous, interesting people who are similar nature, really, fairly resilient and adventure bound.